Good morning, dear students. Today we'll take up the second topic of chapter 11, Biotechnology Principles and Processes. The topic is Tools of Recombinant DNA Technology. I have already told you the process of recombinant DNA technology, how it is made in simple words. In that, I have already told you first recombinant DNA that was produced by Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer by using two organisms, Salmonella typhimurium and E. coli bacteria, right? And then, so now that also, see I told you Salmonella typhimurium, from that the gene of interest was identified, that gene of interest was removed and then was introduced into the plasmid. Requires tools, certain tools, right? For cutting the DNA molecule, then that portion is to be introduced into the host organism or any vector that requires a joining to that vector. So that requires a lot of tools. Likewise, this recombinant DNA technology tools are categorized into different types. Okay, let me tell you all some tools of recombinant DNA technology. The first tool is enzymes. Okay, first in the recombinant DNA technology it requires enzyme. Second, it requires vector. Okay, to carry that gene of interest or target gene to the recipient cell. So recipient cell is also a tool. So I can mention here the third type of tool is the host cell, or you can say recipient cell. One cell which receives it, or the organism which receives that target gene, right? Now under enzymes, for example, I told you that this is a particular DNA. From that DNA or of donor organism, okay? In that I have identified this gene which is giving me a particular phenotypic expression. So I have identified this gene. I want only this gene. Rest part I don't want. So what I will be doing? I will be cutting this particular gene of interest. How I can cut? By using molecular scissors. And molecular scissors are also referred as restriction enzymes. So restriction enzymes act as a scissor to cut the DNA molecule. Restriction enzymes are, remember this, okay? So restriction enzymes used to cut the DNA molecule, also called as molecular scissor. Second enzyme, I told you that I have removed this particular portion from this DNA, and that portion of DNA I need to introduce to a plasmid DNA. For example, this is a plasmid, okay, and the gene of interest was here, which I have removed already by restriction enzyme. That gene I need to insert here. I have introduced it. So before that, the plasmid DNA also I had removed by using restriction enzyme. Then I have introduced this target gene to the plasmid DNA. So now this portion and this portion need to join it. Okay, it need to be glued, right? So that gluing portion or that joining work is done by another enzyme. That enzyme is referred as ligase enzyme. Ligase, it joins the foreign alien DNA to the plasmid DNA. Okay, so this work will be done by the enzyme ligase. Now, when this plasmid DNA we introduce to a host cell, where host cell will be having, for example, a particular bacteria, and this plasmid I am introducing into this host cell. Having this gene of interest, now this plasmid DNA polymerase. Okay, so enzymes are three important enzymes, I can say. The first one is to cut the target gene or gene of interest by using restriction enzymes. Second is to ligate that, so for ligation, ligase enzyme. And third, to prepare multiple copies, so DNA polymerase, polymerization process, many copies are being produced, okay? So DNA polymerase enzyme, remember that. So under this enzyme, there are three enzymes. I told you the second tool is vector. I have already drawn here the vector plasmid. Plasmid is doing the work of carrying the gene of interest to the host organism. Okay, so vector is a carrier molecule. Okay, so a transportation molecule, I can say transporter. Okay, so this is the vector plasmid. Okay, then host cell. Now, why we are selecting this vector? Because it has that self replication property. Okay, host cell is which, in which organism we need to see that phenotypic expression, in which organism we need to produce that factory of products what we want. Okay, so that becomes the host cell. Okay, and the host cell, then this particular replication factory, everything can be seen later. So this is about the tools of recombinant DNA technology. And in this session or in this particular video, I'm going to tell you in detail about restriction enzymes. Now, why it is called as restriction enzyme, everything I'm going to tell you in detail. Okay, slide which I have already told you, there are three tools. Okay, the enzymes, vectors and the host. Under enzymes, there are three enzymes: restriction endonucleases or restriction enzymes, ligases and DNA polymerase. But today we are going to take only restriction endonucleases. Now, why it is called as restriction endonucleases and why not simply molecular scissors? Okay, now why is the name? You can see there is a clear cut picture on the screen. Students, in 1963, when scientists were doing a lot of experiments, they found out that bacteria has its own defense mechanism. Now, when any other foreign organism goes into our body, human body, we create some antibodies. We are having that immunity power to fight against that particular foreign DNA or foreign organism, I can say. Likewise, bacteria also has its own defense mechanism. Okay, for example, a virus which is infecting the bacteria. Okay, so bacteria can protect themselves from that virus infection. How? That means, in 1963, when scientists were doing this experiment on E. coli bacteria, okay, they found out this, they discovered this on E. coli bacteria. Okay, now imagine this is a bacteria called as E. coli. Now on this bacteria, you can see this particular structure. It is called as bacteriophage. What is bacteriophage? I'll write here. Bacteriophage is nothing but it is the virus which is infecting the bacteria. Okay, so there is a bacteria here, if suppose, and if this bacteria is infected by a virus, this is called as bacteriophage. Okay, and this is E. coli bacteria. When bacteriophage infecting the bacteria, meaning it is what is the process actually infecting, meaning bacterial virus is introduced into the E. coli bacteria. And if suppose this genome of the bacteriophage enters into the E. coli bacteria, it will take over the entire machinery of E. coli bacteria. And the future progeny will be with this particular bacteriophage DNA, I can say. This is not happening. That's what I'm telling. The bacteria has its defense mechanism. Okay, so what is that defense mechanism? When this bacteriophage enters enzyme and the second enzyme is nucleases enzyme. Got it? So when a foreign organism or virus is infecting the bacteria will detect that there is one danger coming in contact with me. Okay? That time bacteria will automatically activate some enzyme. The enzymes are methyl transferase and nucleases. What methyl transferase is doing? Very easy to remember. Methyl transferase, meaning methyl group, is transferred. Got it? Methyl transferase. So methyl is transferred. That methyl transferase is doing. Now how and how, all that I am going to tell you now. Nucleases. What is nucleases? Like proteases enzyme, lipases enzyme, cellulase. If you remember, protease digest proteins, lipases digest or meaning deactivate or cut lipids, cellulase cuts cellulose like that. The nucleases digest nucleic acid. It will be cutting the nucleic acid. Which are the two types of nucleic acids we have? They are DNA and RNA. Okay, so what it is doing? It is digesting. It digests the DNA and RNA. What is the function of nucleases? It will be digesting the nucleic acid, DNA or RNA. Okay, so now what will happen when this genome is introduced into this bacterial DNA? In the bacteria, two enzymes got activated. One is methyl transferase and one is nuclease. Now this nuclease has the ability to go and cut at the specific base pairs. For that matter, let us imagine if this particular nuclease is cutting A and T. Wherever there is A and T nucleotide, it will go and cut it. Okay, so cutting will be done here. A and T. Okay, so now when the bacterial genome is the viral genome is entering into the bacteria, this nuclease will go and check where that A and T is there. And for example, if there is A here, there is T here, they will cut that particular DNA and it will inactivate that DNA, viral DNA. But this nucleases will not recognize wherever there is A and T, it will go and cut that A and T. So for that matter, bacteria also has its own genome. E. coli also has its own genome. And if suppose there is A here, there is T here, the nuclease will go and cut the A and T. This will become a suicide, killing enzyme, killing its own DNA, killing its own. This is like a suicide. But this should not happen. That's why methyl transferase, what does methyl transferase enzyme is doing? Methyl transferase is going and adding methyl group here, wherever there is A. If suppose there is A here, it will go and join methyl group. There is C over here, it will go and join methyl group. Okay, like a cap. Okay, as a result, the nuclease will not recognize A and T because there is methyl group. Okay, because it has survived. The original, their own cell DNA is protected by the methyl group added to that particular sequence. Okay, whereas in the bacterial, in the viral genome, it is not there. So this nuclease will go and will cut the nucleic acid or the DNA or what can be a RNA of the bacteriophage. This is called as two complex system. Why two complex system? Because it is involved in two, or because it is involving two enzymes, activating the two enzymes. One is methyl transferase and second is nucleases. Okay, so entire this particular thing is also called as defense modification system. Okay, defense modification system in case of the bacteria. Now in this matter, where is the restriction name comes? Okay, so the thing, why the name restriction enzyme? It is because nuclease is restricting the viral DNA to take over the entire machinery. It is restricting, it is cutting, got it? That's why the name is restriction enzyme. enzyme. You can see that this enzyme of bacterium restricts the replication of viral genome before, therefore it is called as restriction enzyme. You can see all entire picture is explained here. There is bacteriophage. This is the DNA of the bacteriophage. As a result, two enzymes, you can see more clear in this particular picture. Two enzymes getting activated, methyl transferase, and there is restriction enzyme. Methyl transferase will go and will air wherever that particular sequence is there, methyl group will be joined. Whereas here there will be not methyl group, so restriction enzyme will go and cut this particular viral genome. That's why it is also called as restriction modification system, that is acting as a defense in bacteria. Okay, from this logic, the biotechnologists have found out that restriction enzymes, and right now more than 900 restriction enzymes are being discovered, okay, around from 230 strains of bacteria. This was the first when it was found out, okay. Among this also, the first restriction enzyme which was discovered was the HindA2. Okay, now why that HindA2? All that matter I am going to tell you later. Okay, now this is about the restriction enzyme. Why it has got the name? It is very clear. Now let us move on to the next activity of this nuclease. Very easy to remember. Okay, see, nuclease is digesting the nucleic acid, right? Okay, so it can be DNA or can be RNA. So restriction nucleases or the restriction enzymes falls under the nucleases group. Nucleases are of two types: endonucleases, exonucleases, or you can say restriction endonucleases and restriction exonucleases. Now work is same to cut. Okay, to cut wherever that sequence is found, it will be going and cutting that particular sequence. Okay, but what is the function of endonuclease? Endonuclease goes and cut at the specific sequence. Okay, for example, it is ANT here, it will go and cut the ANT. Okay, specific sequence. It can be in the middle, it can be somewhere at the center, it can be at the ends also, no problem. But wherever that sequence is present, that sequence will be cut by using this endonucleases, like inside, like that. You can endo meaning inside, imagine like that. Exo meaning outside. So remember, exonucleases always goes and cut at the end of the bacterium and end of the genome, I can say. Now for that matter, here it is okay. Okay, so it will, the nuclease, for example, it is exonuclease. Exonuclease will go and cut. There is an end over here, it will go and cut. There is one more end here, it will go and cut. It is a kind of defense mechanism. Okay, so that is also there. But in case of recombinant DNA technology, I cannot use exonuclease. But why? Because if suppose this is the DNA, okay, and my gene of interest is here, I want to cut only this gene. But if I am using exonuclease, exonuclease will go and cut this end, it will go and cut this. And what about this ends? What about these regions which I don't want? Again, it will be a problematic situation. Again, that exonuclease I have to take. Again, smaller portion, and that will take a long process. That is the reason recombinant DNA technology is using only endonucleases. That's why in the previous video, if you check properly, it is okay. Here it is not given, but the name given is here: restriction endonuclease. Why restriction endonuclease? Because in biotechnology or recombinant DNA technology, I want to cut specific DNA sequence. For that matter, I require endonuclease. So endonuclease is being used over here. Got it? Why endonuclease and why not exo? Exo is cutting at the ends. Now, there are different kinds of restriction endonucleases. From that also, which endonuclease is helpful in recombinant DNA technology, that we will see now. Okay, there are three kinds of restriction endonucleases. Type 1 type of restriction endonuclease, type 2 target gene. From that 100 base pairs away, it will just go and count the 100 base pairs, and then it will cut over here, and from this 100 base pairs, and it will cut here. So still I'm getting this region, I'm getting this region. What is the use then? Again I have to search for another molecular scissor to go and cut for the restriction enzyme. That's why in recombinant DNA technology, type 1 is not used, because it cleaves 100 base pairs away from the recognition site. This is my recognition site, but it is cleaving, it is cutting 100 base pairs away from that site. Not used. Type 3 I tell you. Again the same matter. My gene of interest is here. Type 3 type of restriction enzyme will go and will find out around 24 to 26 base pairs from here, and it will cut over here. From down 24 to 26 base pairs, it will search and will go and cut here. As a result, again smaller regions are present. I need to cut it because I want only my target gene. So type 3 type of restriction enzyme also not used. Whereas type 2 type of restriction enzyme will go and cut at the specific recognition site. It will find that recognition. Where is that recognition? It will recognize that and it will go and cut that particular target gene. That is beneficial. Hence, recombinant DNA technology is using type 2 type of restriction enzyme. So in this video, I have told you why not exonucleases and why not type 2 and type 3. Got it? So type 2 is very helpful. Next, which are the types of cut this type 2 type of restriction enzyme can do? Okay, or which is beneficial for me or in this recombinant DNA technology? Okay, basically I'll tell you this example. Any recognition or any restriction enzyme, for example type 2, it is recognizing that sequence I told you, right? So it will recognize that particular sequence and then only it is going to cut. If suppose the recognition sequence is CCC from 5 prime and if it is starting GGG ending at the 3 prime region, and down if I am going to check, it is 3 prime C, that is cyto. Mean as also cytosine is always having the opposite base pair, the base will be guanine. Okay, so GGG and again CCC, because opposite to guanine is again cytosine. Now, if I am using a type of restriction enzyme, that type of restriction enzyme is going and cutting exactly at the center. Okay, and if it is cutting exactly at the center, what is going to happen? See here, C and G is there. Between two nucleotides, there is a bond called as phosphodiester bond. Okay. And whereas G and C, the bond is present between this. Okay. If I am talking about the vertical bonds are hydrogen bonds and the horizontal bond is the phosphodiester bond, which you have already seen in the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance. Okay. Yes. So here if I am cleaving the restriction, if I am cleaving this particular side, the phosphodiester bond is being cut, whereas hydrogen bonds are remaining same. It is cutting exactly at the center. So I am getting, if I am cutting this particular scissor exactly at the center, I will get this end, I will get this end, I will get a end. These ends are called as blunt ends. See, this is called as blunt ends. So this will be a blunt end. But it is not used in the recombinant DNA technology because it becomes difficult for the ligase to join that. Ligase cannot do that particular process properly. That's why this type of blunt end or this type of restriction enzymes cannot be used. I will tell you here, see, restriction enzyme cleaves both the strands of DNA. It will be cleaving both the strands of DNA at exactly the same nucleotide position, almost in the center of the recognition site. That is not good. Okay. That's why which type of cleavage, which type of cut is used in recombinant DNA technology is sticky ends. There it was blunt end. But here I am telling about the sticky. Again, there the recognition sequence was CCC, GGG. Again, in this trends, GGG, CCC. Right. But here, I am taking another example. There is a recognition sequence called as GAATTC, and there is a recognition sequence GAATTC from this trend. This is 5 prime, this is 3 prime, this is 3 prime, because they are anti-parallel running always. DNA strands are running anti-parallel using. Okay. Now these are the two strands. If suppose it was blunt end, if it is cutting at the center, it would have cut at A and D, going exactly at the center. This should not happen in case of recombinant DNA technology. So it is using another type of restriction enzyme, and that restriction enzyme is cutting at the sequence. It will go and find that 6 base pair sequence. It will recognize that 6 base pair sequence, which is that 6 base pair GAATTC. And GAATTC from this side, it is cutting only at the portion of G and A. Okay, the same thing I will tell you here. See, if suppose the sequence is GAATTC, okay, G opposite will be C, A opposite will be T, T, A, A, and G. If it would have been blunt, then the scissor would have cut here and here. But I don't want that, I told you. So there are specific type of restriction enzymes which can cleave between G and A. So it is going to cut here. It will make a cut here between G and A, and it will make a cut here between G and A, because G and A is recognizing. So it will be cutting. If suppose this is 5 prime, this is 3 prime, this will be 3 prime, this will be 5 prime. How the segments I am going to get in this particular strand, only G will be present, because G is cut over here. See, G will be here. This portion will go in this strand. In this portion, G and A is cut here. So G has remained here, and this portion has remained here. So it has become like overhang. Okay, so I have cut at the center. So these two strands will be overhanging, and overhanging is always easy to glue. So ligase enzyme can easily gluing the joining portion will be easy on the overhanging portion. That's why these ends are called as sticky ends. These ends, okay, will be called as, since it is creating that overhangs, it is called as sticky ends. So in restriction or recombinant DNA technology, which type of restriction enzymes are used which can create that sticky ends, which is very important. Remember, so in first I told you why not exonucleases and why endonucleases. Second, I told you why two type of restriction enzyme, and in this I told you the restriction enzyme which can create sticky ends, why it becomes easy to stick that overhangs. That's why it is being used over here. Okay. Okay. Now, which was the first restriction enzyme discovered or isolated? Not discovered also. Isolated word is very important. I told you around 900 types, more than that, restriction enzymes have been discovered. First restriction enzyme which was isolated was HIND-D2. Now, why I am not saying HIND? It is HIND-D2. HIND-D2 was a type of restriction enzyme which was discovered from Haemophilus. So, HIND-D2 was discovered from Haemophilus influenza bacteria. It was given the name HIND-D2. For that matter, I will tell you nomenclature, why it has given that HIND-D2 name. Okay. But remember, this is the first type of restriction enzyme isolated. Then why it is not given the name HIND-D1? Because this discovered HIND-D1 was discovered, but isolated, first isolated was HIND-D2. Okay. Why the name is given? I tell you. See, name of the bacterium is very important over here. Now, if I am considering Haemophilus, the name HIND-D2. The first H is taken from the generic name, genus name. So, Haemophilus influenza H is being taken. Then, IN, the second word, see, first is genus. Second two letters is from the specific epithet or species name. So, influenza, so IN. Second two letters will be this from the species. Fourth one is from the strain, type of strain. There are different kinds of strain of Haemophilus influenza also. But this is the strain from that it has been taken. So first word of that, first letter of that, D is being taken. And last is the Roman number. So there can be 1, can be 2. So depending on when it was discovered, it would have been first isolated, then it would have been in 1. But it is not isolated first, in the 2. Second it has isolated in the number 2. You can see the next picture, nomenclature. See, ECOR1, type of restriction enzyme. ECOR1, actually the recognition sequence of ECOR1 is this, GAATTC, GAATTC. Okay, ECO, E is Escherichia, CO is coli, so second is species name. Okay, R is the strain of the bacteria, the strain is actually RY13. There are different kinds. So remember, Escherichia coli RY13. Okay, this RY13. So first is being taken. So R is the letter taken. And then 1 is that based on the number of their discovery, I told you. So this was discovered first. Okay, and isolated also first. Then HIND-D3, Haemophilus influenza, which I explained you here. D is the first word, the strain, and 3, so based on the discovery. BEM-H1, so here also bacillus, so B is taken. Amylo, AM is taken, so bacillus, amylo. H is the strain, and see, H is the strain, and 1 in which the order in which it was isolated. So H1. Okay, so this is about the nomenclature of restriction enzyme. So today I explained you tools of restriction tools of recombinant DNA technology. In that, first I told you about restriction enzymes. Why it has got the name? Because restriction enzyme is restricting the viral DNA to take over the machinery of the bacterial DNA. Restriction endonucleases, all the nucleases are of two types, endo and exo. Exo is cutting at the ends, endo is cutting at the specific location. Then I told you there are three types of restriction enzymes, type 1, type 2, type 3. Type 2 is beneficial because it will go and cut specific sequence. Type 1 is 100 base pairs away, type 3 is around 24 to 26 base pair away, it will go and cut. Then I told you types of cuts this restriction enzyme can do: blunt type of cut and sticky type of cut. Sticky is very helpful because it can be, overhangs can be joined properly. but that is easy for the like basis to join it later. Then I told you about the nomenclature. Of course, I told you the restriction enzymes can identify specific recognition sequence, and that recognition sequence is the palindrome. Reading frame from both the directions remains the same. And then I told you about the nomenclature. First word is the genus. Second two words are from the species. Fourth word is from the strain. And last Roman number is from which the order it was discovered. Okay? Thank you, everyone.